Critical thinking. In this short video, we will explore one of the most fundamental skills that you will need for college or university. Developing your critical thinking skills will help you to develop balanced arguments, express yourself clearly, and read for important information. So it's important to understand what critical thinking is. Rather than just accepting information as true and static, critical thinking involves asking further questions like, how do we know? Is that true for every case or just in this instance? Critical thinkers possess and develop characteristics such as curiosity, humility, willingness to examine one's own beliefs, the ability to distinguish between fact and opinion, as well as seeking clarification. Critical thinking is about being skeptical and challenging assumptions, rather than just memorizing facts or blindly accepting what is being said. Think about this. If you are reading a history textbook, you might ask, who wrote this? And what bias might they have? For example, the person who wrote it might have had a very limited scope of research that only focuses on a particular group within the population. In that case, there would be other sides to the story. The building blocks you need for good critical thinking are background knowledge, the more the better, some criteria for judgment, critical thinking vocabulary, and thinking strategies, like asking yourself questions as you read, and habits of mind, like not accepting something as true until you've had time to examine all the available evidence. Now, here are four ways to begin building some critical thinking skills. First, read for understanding. That means not necessarily reading every single word, but making sure you understand the concept or the motives behind what is written. Then try to separate the hard facts from the arguments or claims that the author is making. Ask for clarification of thinking. Don't assume that you know what someone else means or why they are saying it. Always reflect on what you've learnt. Is it true all the time? How did you arrive at your conclusions? There are many ways to critically think and to take shorthand notes as you read. Here's one example, but feel free to develop your own shorthand style when reading or taking notes. In this example, we've used I to demark important, L to mean learned something new, and an exclamation mark to mean that a big idea surfaced. Critical thinking also involves being able to express yourself clearly. Most important is stating one point at a time. Don't try to argue every thought you've ever had. Just stick to your main arguments. This will allow others to clearly follow your thinking. It's good to elaborate on your thinking. For more abstract ideas, assume that your audience may not understand wide examples, analogies, or metaphors, where you can try to clarify your thinking for others. Consider the following 8 elements. What is the purpose? What question are we trying to answer? What point of view is being expressed? What assumptions are we or others making? What do we know and how do we know it? What are the concepts we're working with? What are the conclusions and do they make sense? And finally, what are the implications? Here are some good habits to have when thinking critically. Being open-minded. Having respect for the truth, which means being open to having your opinion changed. Having respect for others. Being independent. Being fair-minded. Having respect for reason. Having an inquiring mind rather than making assumptions. And having an intellectual work ethic, which means that you're always questioning, especially your own conclusions. Here are some strategies for practicing critical thinking. Use wasted time. Rather than it just being wasting time, try to learn something new or explore a new subject. 2. Redefine how you see things. What's more boring than always thinking the same way? Challenge yourself to see things you're familiar with in new ways. And thirdly, analyze the influences in your life. Why do you think you feel a certain way? Use your wasted time to determine When do you best think, and when can you try learning something new? During what part of the day? Think about things that frustrated you during the day and how you could do things differently. Try not to get too hung up. One of the best ways to approach a problem with a critical mind is to first consider the problem and all of its possible implications. This can be done by putting yourself in someone else's shoes and thinking about what the situation might look like for all the parties involved. In doing this, you will define the problem from all angles. To make the best decision, list all that you are concerned about, what you need to do to solve it, who can help, and what some possible barriers may be. Finally, reframe the problem as an opportunity. What better way to practice critical thinking than to find a solution where there seems to be none? Think about who influences you in your life. Do you feel or react in a certain way because of social convention or because you believe it's what's expected of you? Try to break out of that mold if it constricts you in any way. Remember, the critical thinking is a fundamental skill for college or university, but it doesn't stop there. It's an ongoing process that requires lifelong learning. But once you incorporate it into your life, it will become second nature to you.